First of all, I'd like to ask you, how do you find yourself in this, you know, new situation and having to work from home and, you know, doing interviews from your bedroom or from your couch?
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely different, like being a lot to adjust to. But obviously, you know, it's the right thing to do right now, staying inside, staying at home, staying safe, is saving lives. So, you know, that puts it into perspective. And also I'm with my family, which I'm really grateful, you know, just to be able to spend time with them.
Yeah, that's true. Do you find yourself doing new things, things you didn't have any time to do before?
I mean, usually I love cooking, but I usually don't have time to do it at all. Like, my normal pace of life is like a lot of like takeaway and eating, like standing up.
Yeah.
I feel like, but you know, I have time to like cook now and bake, and I've been like making loads of TikToks.
That's, yeah,
like,
I've seen it. You mentioned your family, and I wanted to ask about your mom, because when I watched this year's Brit Awards, I was quite surprised to find out that your mom was actually a really huge trip hop artist in the 90s, and somehow I can recall her music. Tell me how being a daughter of a musician affected your life and your career, because I'm sure it did.
Yeah, I mean, I think, you know, it's just how I grew up. Like, to me, it's not strange, because it's just like, it was just normal reality for me. I mean, now, in hindsight, I'm just so grateful to have grown up around so many creative people, and that also encouraged my creativity and, you know, wanting to make music in general and express myself, you know, through music. But yeah, you know, just grateful for that.
Yeah, okay. I'm sure your mom is very supportive when it comes to your music. I've seen it on Instagram lately, a picture you were promoting your new single, Boyfriend. Tell me more about this one, because it feels like you want to empower women and to make them remember that it's not only about love, about the affection, about the other person, but also about us when it comes to relationship.
Yeah, that's exactly it. I guess, you know, just wanting to spread the message of the difference between wanting a boyfriend and needing a boyfriend. And I feel like I'm in a place in my life now where I don't really need one at all. But that you can be empowered and strong and independent and want somebody, and really wanting to, like, yeah, stress that point. I think for especially like young people, I think we quite often end up in relationships when we have issues, you know, that we think somebody else can fix.
Yeah.
Whereas actually you need to do that, you know, for yourself first. And, you know, even though, yeah, it might just like sound like a really like sort of fun, lighthearted song, which it is in some ways, I also wanted to make it, yeah, clear to young people, especially young women, I think.
Yeah. Do you think that music can like cure some of our insecurities? How do you feel? Do you feel like writing music, you know, creating music, writing lyrics makes you feel more... more confident, more sure about what do you want in life, what do you want from other people, from yourself?
Yeah, for sure. I think music has helped me like find my voice, like more than musically, but also just as a woman, you know, finding my confidence came massively through probably like making my first album, I think, and I wanted to, you know, empower people through the lyrics. And sort of whilst I was doing that, I was kind of doing it for myself too. And I think that, yeah, making music is always like pushing me further and helping me find my confidence.
The last thing I want to talk about is the new program from BBC that encouraged you to become a teacher, a music teacher for British students. How do you feel as a teacher, and tell us how it looks like?
Yeah, I mean, it's a great, like, honour, I think. I love kids, and obviously, like, it's a crazy adjustment for them too, like, what we're going through now. So to be able to do something that's going to, like, maybe brighten their day a little bit, or, like, put a smile on some of their faces, like, makes me feel really happy. It's, like, an educational programme on the BBC where basically, yeah, they're, like, getting different, like, artists and celebrities to, yeah, teach lessons. So it's going to be interesting. I don't know how I'm going to be as a teacher, but I'm going to try my best.
Are you going to give marks?
No, it's going to be a grade-free class. So
I'm going to keep it chill.
Tinder Maxa.